Tonight, more vaccines are about to be unboxed in our area. St. Louis City receiving nearly 4,000 doses from the state. This as a race against a new coronavirus strain accelerates. Right now, the mutated virus hasn't been found here in the bi-state, but it's not far. It's showing up to our north in Minnesota.
But as fast as it's spreading, it's urgent people get vaccinated. New data from the Centers of Disease Control shows 4% of Missourians have received their first dose of the COVID-19 vaccine. That puts Missouri in 50th place. And the situation isn't much better in Illinois. That state ranks 45th with just 4.4% of residents who have taken their first dose.
It's going to be difficult to improve those numbers if some of our most underserved communities don't trust or simply can't get to a vaccine. Tonight News 4 is watching out for you, digging into St. Louis County's mission to get shots in arms. Emma Hogue is at the county satellite health department in Berkeley.
Right now, an outreach team made up of about 12 people are working to inform and educate those who live in underserved areas. I'm told one of their main focuses is the North County area. And tonight we're getting new details about what resources the health department is offering to make it easier for people who live there to get the vaccine.
I'm pretty amazed every morning that when I wake up, I say, I'm not sure why I'm still here, why I don't have it.
Like many seniors, 72-year-old Paula Gers says she's only left home for church and the grocery store. The North County resident says she's pre-registered on the St. Louis County Health Department's website to get the vaccine.
I'm waiting to hear, and I know that that hinges on whether they get vaccine.
But tonight, this map shows a number of North County residents shaded in light blue are not pre-registered with the health department. A discrepancy local leaders say is likely due to a lack of information.
We all need to operate with the sense of urgency of now.
Damon Broaddus is the new director of health promotion, tasked with leading an outreach team of about a dozen people to target the North County area. The group is utilizing online campaigns, community partnerships, flyers, and door knocking to inform people in underserved and underrepresented communities within North County about the vaccine and where to get it when the time comes.
We need to build trust. We need to build the credibility, not only about the vaccine, but about our partnership and why it's important to the community.
News 4 learned the first mass vaccine site in North County put on by the health department has its own metro bus stop and is serviced by 4 bus lines. The county says it'll provide transportation for those unable to get to a bus stop. They'll also mobilize teams to administer shots to the homebound.
Those disparities have caused tragedy for too long. So we want to look at poverty and injustice and have ways to overcome those vulnerable communities.
While Gers has access to transportation and information at her fingertips, she's fortunate the county has a plan to help others in her community who don't.
I think they have a lot of their own issues to deal with, and it's just overwhelming to them. They've got lots to deal with, and I'm glad that there would be an opportunity for them to have something where they could deal with this more effectively.
We're told the outreach team has already started their efforts. The health department says you can expect to see campaigns and flyers rolling out soon. The health department also plans to release the exact location of that mass vaccine site in North County sometime this week. Reporting in Berkeley tonight, Emma Hogue, News 4.
Health experts are also doing outreach trying to calm fears about the COVID-19 vaccine. So tonight they're explaining to you why the vaccines were made and approved so quickly.
Hundreds of companies were developing these vaccines, universities and pharmaceutical companies. We got lucky with the RNA vaccines because people have been working on that for 10 years. So even though it's a new kind of vaccine, it was something that people were already working on. It's kind of ready to go.
Dr. Presti also says the vaccines were created so quickly because, well, we're in a pandemic and it's needed right now.